Welcome to RPA. In this video, we will discuss about UiPath Test Automation BDD framework. So when we are creating any additional sequence, if you can see here, we have given when and then. These are the blocks where we are using for building an automation flow. I will show you from here. When we are creating a test cases, we can see new test cases, click on next, and here we are not defining any data source as of now, click on create. So now you can see again given, when, and then blocks are available. So what's the use of this block and what is this block is called as, what is the purpose in test automation? So we'll discuss here in detail. Given, when, and then is a part of BDD framework, that is behavior driven development. In the given sections, we can add everything that is necessary for initializing our test cases. Example, setup environment, then changing or assigning variable, and so on. Everything, then what when sections needs to be correctly functions. The when sections should contain our test scope. So the sets of steps executing the necessary steps so we can test our workflow in case of RPA testing. And then sections we can ideally do for the verification, the real test that this test case should do. Remember, a test case without a verification is not a test cases. Of course, all this is just recommendations. We can build those RPA test cases the way we want. Sometimes it is not even possible to do all the verification only at the end. Example, testing the state of a button, or it is at least non-feasible in terms of effort. We want to bring certain best practices to have this framework available so that we can use it for our regular need, as there are more different types of testing. For applications testing, we did the framework which we can build it as per our need. So UiPath team has decided to build given, when, and then for test cases in application testing, especially as we plan with one of the next versions to introduce the selection of template. We can choose either templates that we deliver or even templates we can create by ourselves. So it's our way of working within the framework so that we can create the smooth and flow. So let's understand this login page where we have created this feed for doing login into the UI bank. So if you can see here, we have UI bank applications are available. If you want to perform the login, generally we have built this flow. So in given sections, I did not define anything because I don't have any additions required to be added. But when we are working with any complex type of application, it's always recommended to use given, when, and then, so that our code or automations will be in structured format. In when sections, we have added the complete step what we want to perform it actually, and here in then sections finally we can add verifications like if this equal to this, then this should be passed, or if this equal to that, then that should be failed. So this is how we can define. At any point of time, if we want to add the test cases, simply we'll go here new and then add the test case name, define the locations based on the framework. So if we are selecting the empty test cases, it does not have the BDD framework added here. But if we are selecting BDD test cases, then only the BDD framework will be added successfully. And when we are adding built-in templates, that is no execution templates are available. So here, if we have the execution templates, we can also specify it. When we click on next, that should ask for data. So in source of data, we have these options. If we are selecting, so it will not ask to add the data. If we have existing data, simply we'll go here and select the existing data and then the test data file. So if our data is available in config sheet, then probably we will go ahead with this and select the config file. Now, if we have any other file where our data is available, we can select it on selecting file sections. Data services, if we have created entities in data services, then probably we will use this data service option. And if we have added the data in queue, then probably we'll call this with the queue name. So you have to search here queue name, and then we have all the queue listed, then select this and then we will create the test cases. So this is how easy to add the test data as well as creating the automation flow in within the framework. Even if we have not added the data, we also have to add test data from here, because we have already included the test data available here in the sheet. Then we don't have to define again and again. So generally here, this test data is converted into the JSON format and we can use this test data for our automation need. Now in the screenshot sections, we can see here, all the screenshots has been captured, whichever is required. And as I said, if we have data services available, we can add inside the entity and their services. So that's all from the UiPath Test Automation BDD framework. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.